Your forces all come from a single potential. So dW is supposed to be zero. Now dW is the negative of dV, so dV is also zero.
So at equilibrium?
At equilibrium, the potential is constant. It's dV zero. It attains its minimum. Actually, minimum or maximum, right? Minimum would be stable, maximum would be unstable. We're going to talk about that later.
So that
for me now, mathematically, its derivative with respect to any variable would be zero. Okay? So what? Even if I have two variables, so we have 5 minutes, we can either give a quiz, but let's not do it now. Or if you guys have any question, we can discuss, or we can take a quick example sketch or another example. Yes, Joe?
What's a PMPE?
Principle of minimum potential energy.
So the potential is constant, so the derivative is zero.
Yeah. Yes, Andrew?
So if you were to do this using the force, using work instead of energy, you would just account for theta in your R vector, right?
Account for?
The theta that would be accounted for in your R.
Yeah, yeah. So I'm gonna write dr for this guy, which is simply dx, and dx is related to d theta. And then I'm gonna write dr for this guy, which is simply negative dy, which is again related to d theta. So I have two drs as function of d theta. Multiply them with the forces, the two forces, the spring and mass, and I'm done. Again, I'll get the same equation, but this is easier. Yes?
You said that, well, you apply the equation driving the big hole at equilibrium, so that's why you use x equals L minus L cosine theta?
No, this equation, x equals L 1 minus cosine theta, is valid all over the motion. X may be a function of time, theta may be a function of time, right? What is x? I mean, in our language, here, x is the displacement of the spring from the unstretched position. So initially, this was the unstretched position, okay? And then x is stretched a little bit. Okay, what is this position? The problem says that in the unstretched position, this guy is horizontal. So in the unstretched position, x is zero, it's just x naught, and here I have only L. Okay?
Yeah.
So now from this picture, if this is L, and this is x, and this is L cosine theta, so x is L minus L cosine theta, at any instant. Question? Let's draw this example. It's a hard one. You got to appreciate more and more and less than things. Even at equilibrium. You have two mass here, one mass there. We have a spring. This is 90 degrees. This is 45 degrees. 45 degrees. How many degrees of freedom do we have here in this problem? So these two masses move along these wires. How many degrees of freedom do we have?
2 degrees.
Two. Anybody doesn't see two? I mean, we have one along that wire, independent from this along that wire, because the spring can stretch and contract, okay? So we have 2 degrees of freedom, and actually I can call them like this. This is x2, and this is x1. It's up to you to choose what is your q1 and q2. There are 2 degrees of freedom. I will consider them as the distances along the two wires. And again, because this is heavier, it will just move down more than this guy, right? And we want to get the force in the spring, so the spring will stretch a little bit. We want to get the force in the spring and the angle that will make at equilibrium, okay? If you solve this using Newtonian mechanics, that's okay, it's not hard, but here you will have mg force spring, normal force, the same over there, right? Whereas to me now, again, all the acting forces, all the applied forces are coming from potential, so I can simply write down my potential. What is your potential? Well, it's mg, this guy, so here is negative 2 mg times the vertical distance. What is the vertical distance that it moves from the beginning according to x2? And x2, sine or cosine, this guy, it doesn't matter, so it's 1 over square root, right? And the same for this guy, it's just 1 mg, and the x1, the same angle, it's 45 degrees. Okay? And 1/2 A times the stretch square, the stretch is the length of the spring minus its initial, right? And I need to write down the length of the spring in terms of x1 and x2. This is obvious. This is the length of the spring at any moment. In terms of x1 and x2, this is 90 degrees. So we have Pythagoras. Right? Okay, how you solve it? In Newtonian mechanics, I'm going to solve it by writing down four equations. Maybe one is not important, but I'm going to solve three equations and three unknowns. Right here, what are the two immediate equations? Can you tell me what are your equations? What are your equations? Differentiate, exactly. So V is minimum with respect to all the variables. Partial V, partial X1 equals 0. Partial V, partial X2 equals 0. And these are two, your two immediate equations, okay? Okay, we're done. See you next time.